Hello everyone, my name is Yann Gourvennec. I'm the CEO and founder of Visionary Marketing, and we're going to talk about outbound marketing today. You've already had a lecture about inbound marketing. So what is inbound marketing? Just so that we rehearse a little bit. It's about people coming to your websites and various internet resources through your content. So you're going to generate inspiration through content, through your blogs, through your social media presence, through everything that you create in terms of content, video, podcast, you name it, and inspire people about what you do. If you're in B2B, you're going to focus, for instance, on the problems that your solution is going to solve. If you are in B2C, you're going to focus on what we call design thinking, which is exactly the same thing, basically solving people's problem. So this is inbound marketing. You don't focus about yourself or focus on yourself. You focus on the issue and you document the issue, and then people come to your websites through various search engine optimization techniques. Now, obviously, inbound marketing is very much flavor of the month, as you probably heard. It's not new, been doing it for 20 years, so it's been around for quite a while. But it's certain that inbound marketing is gaining a lot of momentum right now. And quite a few enterprises, not just in B2B, not just in high tech, understand that they have to create inspirational content in order to attract people, as opposed to basically doing just outbound marketing. So here we go. As opposed to inbound marketing, we have outbound marketing. So what is the difference? Well, the difference with inbound marketing is that people come to you because they are interested in what in their own interests, and then they come to your website because of that. With outbound marketing, you're going to basically do a little bit of paid marketing so that people get to your web resources in the same way. But the difference is that it's going to cost you a little bit of dosh. So you're going to have to do it. You're going to have to spend money on it. Now, does that mean that inbound marketing is free and then outbound marketing is expensive? Well, certainly outbound marketing is somewhat expensive, and a lot more expensive than people actually ordinarily think. They picture the web as a low-cost resource, but at the same time, it's not so much as a low-cost resource as it is a resource that makes it possible for you to talk to the whole world. Well, if you decide to. Outbound marketing, therefore, is going to be using various techniques in terms of visibility and performance. We'll get back to that in a moment. So has inbound marketing replaced outbound marketing? Well, the answer is a resounding no. No, outbound marketing still makes up 90% of enterprises' budgets at the moment. And to an extent, it's understandable, because inbound marketing is a wee bit more difficult, a little bit more difficult to handle, requires more effort, requires enterprises to be a little bit more savvy as well. And if you want to set up, for instance, an expert blogging experience program, then you're going to have to muster all the competencies within the enterprise and, you know, bring people together, do a bit of change management, get all these people on board, and then build content which is going to inspire your clients. So inbound is cheaper, and I haven't said free, it's cheaper. This is what we called earned media, because you've earned something from the content that you've created, and then people actually share the media that you have created. It's not free, it's a little bit cheaper. Well, it's a lot cheaper. But at the same time, it's a little bit more difficult. So a lot of enterprises resort to outbound marketing. Outbound marketing is a little bit easier. Well, in a way, we're going to see maybe not so, as Kurt Vonnegut would say. So what are the different techniques with regard to content marketing? Well, there are three main techniques which you can resort to when doing outbound marketing. There's one we call cost per mil, being coming from the French word thousand, and it's actually, as the name goes, cost per thousand impressions. So basically, this is used as, well, we call them eyeballs. Not very nice, but that's the way we call them. It's an impression on an impression basis. So basically, the idea there, and this is very often, this is banners or keywords on Google, for instance, is cost per mil as well. Well, Google is a bit different because they'll do pay per click as well. So we'll see that in a moment. But mostly banners, we pay in that way. Now, what's the drawback? What's the advantage? Well, cost per mil is very expensive. It's very expensive because you're going to have your banners displayed all over the place. It's going to cost you a lot because a lot of people are going to see this, these famous eyeballs. Doesn't mean necessarily that people are going to click on the banners. Does that mean that you shouldn't use banner advertising? Because I hear very often when I hear people say, well, cost effectiveness is not there on banner advertising because people don't click. Well, the answer is another resounding no. You should use banner advertising. There is a reason for it. Banner advertising doesn't produce forcibly clicks, but it produces top of the mind awareness. So if you're trying to install a new brand, a new logo, a new motto, and you want people to remember you, then you're going to use banner advertising, because banner advertising is going to be mass advertising. Probably not very effective. Probably people are not going to click on it. It's going to be very expensive. But at the same time, you're going to see a lot of people who haven't clicked on it but have remembered it. So that means that when you design a banner, you're going to have to be very, very, very savvy in the way that you organize it so that people actually remember you and that the message that you've imprinted on them is good and easy to remember. Very similar to advertising, to an extent. Well, it is advertising. Then we have pay-per-click. So pay-per-click is this sort of miracle cures of the internet. People will tell you, you know, you only pay for what people have clicked on. And to an extent, it's true. Google advertising, Google AdWords, famous Google AdWords, is there. It's pay-per-click. So it's slightly a bit more complex than that, actually, because it's pay-per-click. But at the same time, prices vary because there are auctions behind that, depending on how many people are buying which keywords. So prices are sort of fluctuating. But what I have noticed is, on average, obviously my average doesn't mean anything because it depends on what you're talking about, whether you're talking about consumer products or whether you're talking about B2B products or expensive products or cheap products. But banner advertising is going to, Google AdWords advertising is going to cost you around about €1 per click. As I say, it's an average. It doesn't mean anything. It goes from 0.01 to €30 per click. So it's very varied and it changes all the time. So is it a miracle cure? It's not bad. It's actually quite effective because you only pay for what people have clicked on. Now, be careful though, because a click doesn't mean that somebody's going to buy from you. It only means a click. So sometimes appearances can be deceptive. You have good numbers on your Google AdWords campaign, but at the same time, it's not providing the results you're expecting. So it's difficult. The great difficulty, and probably Frederick will dwell on that and explain to you the subtleties of how to implement and hone your Google AdWords campaign. You have to be very selective on the Google AdWords keywords that you're going to select. And very often, I see marketeers spend a lot of money on Google AdWords without thinking. And they say, okay, you know, it's just pay-per-click. So hey presto, just buy keywords and then here we go. But then you have to be very careful with certain agencies, the way they sell the keywords. They're going to try and maximize their profit by trying to use the broadest keywords as possible. Now, let's assume that you're in B2B, for instance, and then you're doing, say, Ethernet networks. You see, very, very technical. So, cable networks for communications. And you want to buy the word networks. Well, then you have to be very careful. Because if you buy the word networks and then you check the Google AdWords keyword tool, then Google will tell you that most of the people that actually look for the networks keyword are actually searching for social networks. So, in essence, you're going to get loads of clicks which have nothing to do with your target. So you have to be very, very selective. You have to be very, very careful. And despite what people think, Google AdWords campaign require a lot of knowledge and effort so that your teams actually spend a lot of time carefully checking the words that you've bought. Because otherwise you're going to do loads of clicks, it's going to cost you a lot of money, and it's not going to produce any results because the clicks that you're going to get are not going to stay on your website. Plus, there is an issue with Google AdWords. It's very effective, but it's a bit like a flash in the pan. So you get a surge of visits, and then they'll go. As soon as you stop paying, they'll go. Banners will create some retention in the long run, like any advertising campaigns, because there'll be top of the mind awareness. Inbound marketing will produce that the same kind of results in the long run. So this is why inbound marketing is not so cheap, because you're going to have to wait for a bit of time before it actually brings something to you. And then the last bit is probably the one most sought after. It's the cost per action. So cost per action means basically that the internet user is going to click your banners and buttons and what's it, and he's going to do something with it. He's going to be taken somewhere, doing something, registering for an event, buying a product, filling in a form, etc. Cost per action is also called cost per lead, or sometimes cost per sales when you're actually selling something, as long as it's not too expensive, because it's more difficult to do cost per lead, per sales, if you're actually selling expensive products. And cost per action, you can achieve through various means, like affiliate marketing, for instance, is going to be one of those. Actually, one of the agencies that we work with is in affiliate marketing. So cost per action is very effective because you get straight to the point, but then is going to be the most expensive way of doing outbound marketing. So, in essence, how effective is outbound marketing? Well, it's a bit like looking at it on the scales. Left-hand side, you're going to have money. You're going to have to spend money to get a result. Right-hand side, you're going to have to be very careful with your objective, with the method that you use, exactly as I explained with Google AdWords, and how you measure your return on investment. So, think about it. Outbound marketing is not superseded by inbound marketing. Inbound marketing and outbound marketing go hand in hand. If you don't have any budget, of course, inbound marketing is going to be a solution for you. But if you have a bit of budget, think about balancing the two maybe a little bit more evenly than having 10% and 90% on the other. Now, the one thing that you have to remember at the end of this presentation is that despite the fact that outbound marketing is paid marketing, doesn't guarantee a result. You have to be very serious, very to the point. Now, Frederick is going to take up on me on this issue and explain to you the nitty-gritty of outbound marketing. Thanks for listening and see you. Bye.